Okay, so I just told you that C program is a set of functions. So function is important in C, right? Because when you want to write a program, right, the complex program, you need to subdivide the program into the segment, and the segment can be called a function. So why do we have to do or to subdivide the program into the function? Because when you write a function, you have to name it. And the name of the function will present something that is related to the how can I say, the function or the task that function does, right? So when you name correctly, right, when the other programmers go to see your program, and then they will understand the program easily, right? So the most important thing that you have to do in the writing a function is to have to name the function as its task. Okay, so I don't recommend you to write a program like this: main and then function one, and then function one then call function two, function two call function three. It's not acceptable. Okay, this one is not a good program style, but it's easy to make you understand about the structure of the program, right? When you write a function, the programming function. This is a list of the pros or the advantages of using function, right? The first one is divide the program into separate well-known function, right? If you want to write a whole or the big project or the big program, right, you may need to subdivide into the smaller part, and it can give the smaller function into different programmers. Okay, this simplifies the process of getting the total program to work. This is the first one for the simplicity. The next one is understandable. Understanding, coding, testing multiple separate functions is easier than doing the same thing for one big function. Okay, so when you finish some parts of the program, you can write it, you can test it, you can debug it, and make it clear that this one is okay or correct. So that would be better if you put them all together in a big function and try to debug them. Okay, this is why I need you all to write a project. And a project, we need 4 or 5 students in this project. And then it must be easier if I give the project for just only one programmer or one of you. But working in group, right, this is a skill that you need to be to practice. Okay, you need to lead someone. The leader has to lead the group, or someone needs to, okay, to manage the team, to separate the task, okay, and have arguments, right? This is the things that you may have to study about how to work in team. Okay, this is one LO, if you could remember. The next one, if a big program has to be developed without using any function other than main, what's happened? Everything will be put in main, so, it's difficult to maintain, okay? And the next one, all the library in C contain a set of functions that programmers are free to use in their programs. This function can be predicted and pretest. Okay, you can use the predefined function from the library. Like C library programmer can also write their own functions. Okay, if you are a better or a sophisticated programmer, right, you can have your own function and then you keep into a files, or you can compile into a libraries. So you can also have your own library as well, and .h, right? And you can use the double quote in order to identify that this one is not the system libraries. And the last one, when a big program is broken into smaller functions, right, then different programmers working on that project can be divide the workload by writing different functions. So this is what is about the workload, right? If you have 10 programmers, you can subdivide into 10 parts and then you can divide load by 1/10 right? The workload will be divided by 10. Okay, this is the advantages of using function. Okay, this is an example of how to write a program in order to find a number that is even or odd using functions. Okay, this is very simple, right? You can just separate even and odd or even odd functions in order to check whether this number is even or odd, right? This is a simple function. Okay, but this one is an important part in function, because in function you can pass a parameter, and we have two kinds of parameter passing in C. The first one is called by value. The second one is called by reference. Okay, do you remember about the differences between these kinds of parameter passing? Okay, if you forget about it, I will recall you again. Call by value. The value of variables are passed by the calling function to call that function. Okay, just copy the value. But for call by reference, the address of the variable. Okay, this one is different. The first one is value will be passed. The second one, the addresses of the variables are passed. Okay, so the reason why these are different. Okay, we will start from call by value. In this method, right, the call function create new variables to store the value and pass of the argument passed to it. Then the call that function uses a copy of the actual argument to perform its intended task. So just a copy of the variable or the value will be copied to the variable. And then everything will be changed in the function, right? The value that variable will be changed inside the function. I mean, we modify, right? If the call function is supposed to modify the value of the parameters passed to it, then the change will be reflect only inside the function. But when it go back to the main function or the calling function, no change will be made to the value of the variables. Okay, this is why we call by values, or sometimes we will call by copy. We can just copy the value to the place in the function, in the another functions. And if you change the value, okay, in that function, if you print it out or you check the value can be changed. But when you go back or the control go back to the calling function, no change will be made, okay? But this one will be different to the next one. Okay, this is a call by value program, right? You can check it out later. But call by references, in this method, right? The address will be copied instead, will be copied. So the change to the variables according to that memory location. So when you change the variables or the value inside, it will change, it will modify the value in the calling function as well. Okay, we use this in order to get something from another function like scanf. Do you remember scanf? When we use scanf, you have to use ampersand. Ampersand is a way that you will send the reference or the address of that variable. The reference or the address of that variable. And then if there is any modification in this storage, the value will be changed because of the call by reference. So we can also use the call by, this is an example of call by reference. Okay, this one is send address, right? Star N, right? If you could remember, this asterisk means send the address. And then once you change the value here, right? And then num will be changed also in this main function. Okay. Okay, and this will be the advantages of the call by reference, right? Okay, I'm not going to read it, all right? Maybe you can check it out later. And this one is the disadvantage of using the call by reference. This is a simple program when you want to swap a value A and B, right? If you use A and B in function in the main function, nothing will be happen even you swap the value from A and B. But if you use this one is using the pass by value, but the second one swap call reference, this is pass by reference, you send the address, right? When you in this program, when you swap the value according to the location in the main memory, okay, C and D will be changed, will be swapped. Okay, this is the way that we have to use the pass by value and pass by reference. Okay, here we are to the pointers. Okay, before we go to pointer, anyone, do you have any questions about the pass by value or pass by reference? Okay, if you all don't have the question, I will continue with the pointers. Okay, pointer is important. And also in, how can I say, all programmers, they don't like the pointers in C because they will say that pointer is very difficult to maintain. Pointer is difficult to understand and write a program, right? But I will say that pointers is an efficient construct in C that can make your program run faster and very efficient. The reason why I'm wanting to talk today, okay? Starting from every variable in C has a name and a value associated in it. But when a variable is declared, a specific block of memory within the computer is allocated. It means that if you want to define variables, the name and the value has to be assigned. And then assigned to where? Assigned to a specific block of physical memory. And also the variable will be kept in a table we call symbol table. The symbol table will collect the name, variable, the address of memory, and many types and many other values, right? The most important things is the name value and the address of this variable. Okay, but if you want to handle with the address of the variable in C, right? You may have to call it like you are using pointer. For this example, if you want to declare a pointer, you can use data type, asterisk sign, and then the name and semicolon. For example, if you want to define pointer to integer, you can use integer star pnum. If you want to declare a pointer to character, you can do like this. If you want to declare a pointer to floating point number, you can use this, okay? And if you want to assign your value, right, you can use integer x is equal to 10, right? X is a name, 10 is a value, and then address of x is a physical memory of x. And if you want to point a PTR pointer to integer, you want to know the address of x, what shall we do? You can just simply use PTR is equal to address of x. Okay, once again, if you declare x as an integer and then you give it value 10, okay, and you define another name PTR. PTR is a pointer to integer, and then you use the assignment statement PTR equals to at ampersand x or address x. So the address of x will be kept in PTR variable. Okay. So it is a way that you can get the address of an integer, right? For this example, This is because when you are trying to declare a variable, integer variable, right? Two bytes will be allocated, okay? And assuming that the compiler will locate it at the location 1003 and 1004, right? So the address X will be equal to 1003, okay? So 1003 will be the starting address of X in memory, but because it is integer, so the location will be 1003, 1004, right? Because there are two bytes to be used for keeping integer variable. Okay, when we write pointer is equal to address X, then pointer will be shown as 1003. Okay, this is pretty easy, right? Pointer is address, variable is just variable. We keep the name inside the name and value. Okay. And this one is an example of how to add two integer using pointers and functions. Okay. This program is very simple, right? You can just simply get two numbers, first number and second number, right? And you can use scanf. Now, the value will be stored in num1 and num2. And then if you want to sum these two variables up and keep it in the total, right? You can send the address of three variables here into this function sum. Okay, and it's really easy. Then you can just simply use a pointer to integer A, B, and T, right? When you sum them up, right, and write it into T star 3. So this one is to add these two variables to T, and then the value will be changed to the total in the main function as well. So in this way, you can just, if you run this program, right, you can get the number 23 and 34, right? You can end up with the total, which is 57. Okay, this is a simple program in order to add. Okay, this one is a pass by reference. You can pass two variables as the input, right? And you can pass T as an output that will be shown, right? Will be written or will be printed in the main function. Okay, this is a way that the pointer, this one is a pass by reference. Okay, thus. Okay, that's all about the overview or the introduction about C programming. I hope you can remind about this, right? I know that during the term break, right, you will forget everything about C program, UX, UI, everything. Am I right?